Hello everyone, welcome to this video. This is the first video of the introductory course on electromagnetic design of switch reluctance motors or SRMs. And in this video, we will discuss the course objective. Like other courses that are available in the channel, in this course also we will consider these two benchmark induction motors, and we will design a corresponding switched reluctance motor. Okay, so in this figure you can see two benchmark motors. One of them is from the Siemens company and another one is from the WEG. And here you can see the sketch of the rotor core and the stator core of the benchmark induction motors. The number of stator slots is equal to 36 and the number of rotor slots is equal to 26. This is a single layer winding. Here you can see the properties of the induction motor. The output power is 1 HP and the rated speed is 1400 RPM. The number of poles is equal to 4, right? The synchronous speed is equal to 1500 RPM. And as you know, because of sleep, the rated continuous speed is lower. Here you can see the data sheet of the Siemens motor, right? The rated speed of the motor when we fed the motor with 50 Hz. So the outer stator diameter is 125 millimeters and the stack length of the stator and rotor core is equal to 70 mm. Here you can see the rotor core and also the stator core. As you can see, the stack length is equal to 7 centimeters. So we are going to design a corresponding SR motor with the same characteristics. Just instead of the sleep, considering the sleep, I consider the synchronous speed, right? So we are going to design a motor for the same output power, but considering the synchronous speed and the same outer stator diameter, right? Here you can see the sketch of the SR motor. So the aim is to have a stack length lower than or equal 70 mm, right? So if we can design a motor with a lower stack length, it means that we can increase the power density of the motor. So the aim is to use the same frame as these induction motors and just change the active parts, right? By active parts, I mean the parts that are involved in the electromagnetic energy conversion. So the line-to-line terminal voltage of these induction motors is equal to 400 volts. Here you can see the rated voltage, 400 volts. When the connection is a star, as you know, these motors are three-phase motors. And the RMS value of the line-to-line voltage is equal to 400 volts. So if we use the same three-phase power supply and use a three-phase rectifier, so the DC component, the value of rectified voltage is equal to, let's check from this reference. Here you can see the three-phase, the circuit of the three-phase rectifier, the peak value that we can have is equal to the, and this is the DC component, but the peak value is higher. The peak value is equal to the peak value of the line to line, right? Line to line voltage. So the peak value of this number is equal to 564 volts. So we assume that we will use the same three-phase power supply to feed this switched reluctance motor. So in this case, we can compare terminal currents and so on. This is a good comparison, right? Because we have many standards for induction motors, and we can use these numbers that are available and design a switched reluctance motor, and later we try to optimize the motor and how much we can increase the torque density and power density. What about the efficiency? The efficiency class of these induction motors is IE1. And for this output power, this amount of output power at the full load, the efficiency is 72.1. As you know, we have different efficiency classes, and detailed explanations of these slides are available in videos of the induction motor design course. So if you are interested, you can refer to those videos. So here you can see the table, the value of efficiency for different number of poles at different rated powers, right? And this is our case, 72.1. IE1 efficiency, 50 Hertz. And this is the rated output power. So for the SR motor, also we consider this efficiency, right? The desired efficiency should be higher than or equal 72.1. And for the induction motor, we have the power factor, right? But because here we use rectification of the voltage, and we have a DC power supply, so I didn't mention the power factor here. Okay, so this is our course objective. We are going to design a switched reluctance motor with these parameters, and finally compare with the existing induction motor. So here we have few slides. As I said, you can refer to the induction motor design course first few videos and review this explanation of these slides. Here you can see the right properties of the frame, the sizes that we have, and the frame size, right, and the stack lengths of the motor. In videos of the induction motor design course, I explained these standards, right? So you can refer to those videos, and if you have any questions, you can write below this video. So thanks for watching.